I tried my best to study, but I really don't understand things. What is this analog and digital signals?
Oh, Miri, you took a complicated topic to study on your own. Don't worry though. Tere, the Einstein mouse has all the answers for you.
Oh yeah, right.
See, Miri, analog signals are continuous flow of electricity. For example, take this light bulb. If I keep playing with the dimmer, it is a continuous increase and decrease in the light of the bulb. Oh, so that's why analog signals are shown in waveform. Where, if this is light and this is dark, then these are infinite small changes to the intensity of light. Absolutely right. You are smarter than you think. Now, if I switch the light on and off like this, it is similar to a digital signal, where the signal has only two values, on or off.
Now I understand these graphs. This means in digital, this is on and this is off.
So the graph represents only two values, one off and the other on.
Precisely, Miri. Now I hope you understand.
Get back here, mister. I have understood by a long shot. So why does it make so much of a difference whether things are analog or digital? And you said you can explain. So please do that.
Okay. Calm down. You see, Miri, nowadays most electronic devices work on digital signals. Computers are the best example of this. Computers work on electricity. And digital signals define all computing processes in a on-off system instead of the continuous wave of analog signals. You might have heard of computer language, binary, using 0 and 1.
Yeah. Well, there.
0 means off and 1 means on. So this enables the computer to use digital signals to run all of its operations.
So where are analog signals used?
Miri, pay attention. I am telling this for you.
Sorry, the music was so nice.
See, Miri, anything that has continuous change is analog. This gramophone, for example, is an analog device. Sound from gramophone has all frequencies, so it is an analog device. So have you understood now?
Yes, it's a little better. But why aren't all devices analog?
Digital has many advantages over using analog systems. I will tell you some major differences. Imagine a photocopier. Take a copy of a photo, then take a copy of the copy, and then continue taking copies of the copies. As you will notice, the quality of the image will keep becoming worse as we take more copies.
Why does that happen?
What happens is that most analog signals carry a lot of unwanted data with them. As we replicate it, the noise becomes more and more and the quality of the image goes bad.
Yes, so when we take a lot of copies of a photo from a computer, that doesn't happen because the file is digital and so it doesn't have any unwanted data on it.
Absolutely, Miri.
So, Tiri,
now digital is everywhere. Cell phones, calculators, music players, TVs and even cars.
Yes, Miri. In some cases though, analog offers excellent quality and therefore is still preferred over digital format.
Like where?
Like in filmmaking, many directors still prefer using analog films over digital formats as they feel films give them a larger color depth and clarity over digital. But digital technology is also catching up fast.